In this problem, we've built a simple machine for measuring mass without relying on gravity. So the mass is hooked up to this spring that has a relaxed length of 4 centimeters. And then you start rotating the device, and the spring is going to stretch and stretch and stretch until this rod becomes vertical. At that point, the spring is now 8 centimeters long. In other words, it's been stretched by an additional 4 centimeters relative to its equilibrium length. Now, just intuitively, you can imagine that a larger mass would require a slower rotation rate to get this thing stretched into the vertical position. A smaller mass would require a higher rotation rate, so you should be able to use the rotation rate to figure out what the mass is that's attached to this thing. One other important specification is the spring constant, 25 newtons per meter. And in part A, we're asked for the mass of the sample if our rotation rate is 2.5 rotations per second. Now, to get into more appropriate units, we want radians per second. We're going to take that 2.5 rotations per second and multiply by a conversion factor of 2 pi radians per rotation. This gives me my angular velocity in radians per second, 15.71 radians per second. So somehow the key to the problem is going to be in the force analysis on this mass. The mass is accelerating toward the center of curvature here, and it's because there's a force on it pointing to the center of the curvature, and that's the spring force due to the stretching of the spring. So we write down Newton's second law. Either you can say, well, gravity points straight down, so it's not part of this horizontal analysis for the centripetal acceleration. Or I can say I'm actually doing this in the absence of gravity. So you could measure masses on a spaceship if you wanted by using a device like this. And that force that points to the center of curvature is given by Kx, Hooke's law for the spring. Our mass is little m. And our acceleration we can write as v squared over r for the centripetal acceleration. But it's more appropriate here to use the formula in terms of the angular velocity. The centripetal acceleration is r omega squared. Well, this means we can solve for our little mass. That's kx over r omega squared. We plug in our spring constant. X is the stretch length of the spring relative to its equilibrium length, and that's 4 centimeters or 0.04 meters. R is the radius of curvature of the path of this mass, and that's 8 centimeters. And omega was 15.71 radians per second, and I've got to square that. And we get 0.0506 kilograms, which would look nicer as 50.6 grams. Part B is a really short follow-up question about the linear speed of the sample at this rate of rotation. So we just use V equals R omega for that. And the radius of curvature is 0.08 meters. And the angular velocity, 15.71 radians per second. And we get 1.26 meters per second for that. One final point here. We used A equals r omega squared for the centripetal acceleration in this problem because it was the fastest way to answer part A. But if you wanted to use that centripetal acceleration is v squared over r, you could have solved part B first and got that v of 1.26 and plugged it in there, and you'll get the same answer for the mass. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.